can get their hometown fans a victory here this afternoon. Got a good-sized crowd here inside the Todoroki Arena. And why not? It's a clash between two titans here in the B-League, Nagoya Diamond Dolphins with a 25-11 card. Here it is on your screens. They're in third place in their conference. In the other division, Kawasaki Brave Thunders with a record of 31 victories against 11 setbacks. And so they are also in third place. Both these teams definitely want to be able to make sure that they come up with a victory here to solidify their position on the top of the standings. They'd like to stay there as long as possible so that they can get off to the playoffs without any hitch. Nice look there, the mascot of the Kawasaki Brave Thunders. And this was the encounter yesterday. Both these teams battled each other end to end from the opening buzzer. Looking at the top scorers for the winners, Nagoya, they were led there by Cody Clark with 16 points, 3 rebounds, 4 assists, and 1 steal. Ray Ray Parks also contributed 15 points, 1 assist, and 1 steal. Scott Etherton helped them out as well with 14 points, 18 boards, and 7 assists. Good numbers also from Saito. Look at his line. 12 points, 3 boards, and 8 assists. So a lot of heroes. Those are the game stats from yesterday. Nagoya winning despite the fact that they actually shot. Their percentage was a little lower from 2-point distance. They shot a whole lot better though from 3. 40% as compared to 25%. Free throws, just about even there. 14 made for Kawasaki, 15 for Nagoya. But today is a brand new day as we take a look at the Nagoya Diamond Dolphins, their lineup. As usual, they'll be relying on Ray Ray Parks, number 1. Cody Clark, number 4. Taito Nakahigashi, number 12. They have Scott Etherton as well, wearing jersey number 43. New addition, Ovi Soko, who's wearing number 16. He's only played 5 games for them after transferring. He used to play for the Shiga Lake Stars. But so far, pretty good numbers. 12 points, 6 rebounds, and 1 assist. And they also have a new youngster in Seiga Sakamoto. Here's the starting 5 for the Nagoya Diamond Dolphins. They will start out with Saito, Clark, Harimoto, Nakahigashi, and Etherton. Now let's talk about the good performers for Kawasaki yesterday in their defeat. Janning had 21 points, 5 assists. Fuji had 20 points, 3 rebounds. Nick Fazikas had 11 points, 11 boards, 2 assists, and 1 steal. They want a better showing here. Give their fans at the Todoroki Arena something to be able to go home with a big smile. Here we have the Kawasaki Brave Thunders. And there, once again, they announced the king last because he is the king, Nick Fazekas, the main man here for the longest time for the Kawasaki Brave Thunders. There's Coach Kenji Sato as they paraded in their lineup. They have Fuji, Fazekas, Janning, Hasegawa, and Jordan Heath. We got our three officials handling proceedings this Sunday afternoon. We have got Referee Okawara, Referee Hosoda, and Referee Akiyama. We're going to be focusing on these two gentlemen all throughout the night. You can see Fazekas there on the left, and you have Scott Etherton on the right. Decent numbers for both these individuals, but as far as Scott Etherton's concerned, he's got a big smile on his face because his team came away with a win yesterday right here at the Todoroki Arena. Can they make it back-to-back? We'll find out in just a bit. Once again, the starters for both these squads, the Diamond Dolphins have Saito, Clark, Harimoto, Nakahigashi, and Etherton. For the hometown squad, the Brave Thunder starting out with Fuji, Fazekas, Janning, Hasegawa, and Heath. For the Kawasaki Brave Thunders, they were actually on a six-game winning streak before losing yesterday. So they were feeling real good about themselves until they got slapped in the face yesterday. Nagoya winning that encounter, 89-84, brought them right back down to earth. Looking at the overall performance, last five games of Nagoya, they've done quite well. They've won four out of their last five. Actually, a big scalp that they took down yesterday in the number three squad, the Kawasaki Brave Thunders. Looking to make it back-to-back here this Sunday afternoon. Let's find out. First possession will go to the visiting squad there in white. That's the Nagoya Diamond Dolphins. Mark's not starting here today. Sometimes he'd start, sometimes he'd be coming off the bench. Etherton, not a good pass. Turnover on the first possession. Janning pushes it forward. Fuji trying to make his move against Scott Etherton. He should be quicker. Let's see if he settles for an outside shot. He does. Puts it up and hits. It's a three. Yuma Fuji on the board first. Cody Clark will give it up. Etherton. Nice look inside. Easy basket. No! It's going to rim out. Tenketsu Harimoto. Sorry miss there. Should have been 3-2. Now still 3-0. Mazekas. Nice handoff. Fuji gives it out. Heath for three. No. Still at 3-0. Already a minute gone here in the first period. An attack inside. No foul is going to be called there. Takumi Saito didn't like the non-call. Fazekas for three. Bang! It is now 6-0 here for Kawasaki. Don't leave the king open. He will make you pay. That gets the crowd in it early. Not to mention the fact that Kenji Sato cheering there loudly from the sidelines. Clark will lose it. Another turnover here. Janning inside will miss, but Jordan Heath there. A quick timeout will be called here by Coach Sean Dennis. Things are getting out of hand very early here at the Todoroki Arena. Eight minutes, 6 seconds still to be played here in the first period. Kawasaki up 8-0. Nagoya still to get on the board. Early entry here for Ray Ray Parks. Scott Etherton is going to be pulled down there by Harimoto. Just wanted to make sure there was no easy basket, but Ray Ray Parks has been inserted. Look at the quick hands there from Harimoto, almost with a steal, but an ill-advised pass. Fuji talking to the referees there. They might review this for an unsportsmanlike foul because you saw Harimoto actually tugged on the arm. But Fuji continues to talk to the referee saying he got fouled earlier. Watch it here. There's a steal. Passed it back. Cody Clark with a counter steal. And look at the way he pulls down Scott Etherton. Let's see if they're going to deem that an unsportsmanlike foul. That's a big call. If it is on Harimoto, that gentleman there on your screens, that's going to mean two free throws plus ball possession. He shouldn't have pulled on the arm. Let's see. It is an unsportsmanlike foul. All he had to do was just swipe at the basketball, get the foul, it would have been it. But now an unsportsmanlike foul will give two possessions, two free throws first, and then possession for Scott Etherton. But he missed the first. Hasegawa trying to appeal to a higher court there. He will be denied, that's for sure. They went to the video replay. There's no way they can reverse that. Now on the board, Kawasaki still up though by 7. Let's see, they try to go to Parks coming off the bench here. Saito puts up a long one, will be short. Looks like there's no fluidity to the offense here of the boys in white, at least here in the first period. They did more than enough yesterday to hack out a 5-point victory. Janning, yes! Already 3 threes here for Kawasaki. They are 3 out of 4 for 75%. That's going to drop there. That's going to cut the lead down to 8. Hasegawa might have to be replaced here. Ooh, there's a, he got hit there. I see he was on his way down. Not turning out to be a good afternoon here for Hasegawa. He got called for the unsportsmanlike foul and now he got hit in the eye. Janning. Operating the outside. Yuma Fuji for 3. Yes! That's their 4th 3-point shot here in the first period. Already 6 points for Yuma Fuji. And the lead is now at 11. At 14-3. Nice reply there by Etherton. Janning. Harassed in the backcourt. Gets it through, but Nick's gonna lose it. Easy slam here for Scott. Scott had a good outing yesterday with 14 points, 18 rebounds, and 7 assists. He gets a rebound there. And the boys in white are off and running. Clark will set it up now, up against Janning. He feels he's got the advantage inside. Great pass. Parks with a layup. Parks with a good cut. Gets the pocket pass. Scores there. And a timeout will now be called by Kawasaki. Watch this cut. Hanging in the air, laying it up. And the lead of Kawasaki has been whittled down to 5. Back to the action here. 6 minutes, 2 seconds remaining in the first period. So far, this game has been played with streaks. Good starting streak here for Kawasaki. They were able to build a lead of 11. Open 3. One of their few misses. Only their second miss from 3-point distance. Scott. To the wing. Cody Clark, open 3. Yes! From a lead of 11, it's now been cut down to 2. Nice run. This time for Nagoya. Almost a turnover. Yes, it is a turnover. Yutaro Suda has checked in. There's Ray Ray Parks on your screen. Bring it down now is Tatsuya Ito, the backup point. A lot of movement. Parks free. Tries to create for himself, will eventually lose it. Another turnover here for Nagoya. I think that's five already. That's not gonna count, but you can see Janning and the rest of the Kawasaki Brave Thunders in rhythm here. Yutaro Suda with his first personal foul. Jordan Heath will return to the action. Suda hits. That is Yuma Fuji. Scott on the other end. That might be a goaltending violation. It is. Heath should have just let that one go. That could have rimmed out. He gave him the easy 2 points. Kumagai now in the ball game. Kumagai with a foul. And there you saw the goaltending violation. Scott makes the bonus free throw. He's now got 8 points to go with 2 boards and 2 assists. Let's see if they try to run the offense through Nick once again. They go to the wing. Easy basket there. This player stumbled to the floor. Back to a 3-point lead here for Kawasaki. Ito. Cops out. Will ask for it back and gets it. Nice setup there. Clark for three. Yes! And we are tied at 18. Our very first deadlock of the ball game. Coming back from 11. We're now tied. Fuji will miss. Ito waiting for his teammates with a handoff. Scott. There's Parks with a floater. That'll drop. Parks now with 4 points. And this is the first taste of the lead for the Nagoya Diamond Dolphins at 2018. 3.5 remaining in the first canto. Exciting ball game we've got here. Fazekas kisses it off the glass. Parks says, that was my bad. Came in to help out. Clark now will take some minutes off together with Scott Etherton. So in is Ovi Soko together with Ray Ray Parks. And now the star of the Kawasaki Brave Thunders, Ryusei Shinuyama, a member of the Japanese national squad, is now on the floor. Always coming off the bench. Averaging close to 20 minutes a ball game. And he does multiple things for his squad. Parks comes out and gets it, puts up a three, no. Obi Soko with the offensive rebound. Parks left open, double clutch, that's a good pass. They might lose it, eventually they do. Another turnover here. Already 6 turnovers and scoring in the other end. Are the Kawasaki Brave Thunders. Now a 3-point lead. Ito to Parks. Nice quick hands there from Janning. Pablo Aguilar is going to make his first entrance. Together with Satoru Maeta. Look at the numbers of Aguilar yesterday. He had 7 points, 2 boards, and 3 steals. 3-point lead still here enjoyed by Kawasaki. Kumagai there went for the steal, and it looked like Ray Ray Parks was wise to his tactics. Carino on the floor now for the first time. That's going to be the first personal foul there on Ray Ray Parks. Pablo Aguilar gives him a hug and says, thank you very much. But I'm holding on to the ball. Don't make the steal. I take care of this ball so well. There's confirmation. First personal foul on Ray Ray. Under 2.5 minutes remaining. We're in the opening quarter. 3-point lead for Kawasaki. Let me see the patience here of Aguilar. Not really trying to contribute as early as he possibly can. He knows he's still a little cold. Kuma guy's gonna lose it. Ito. Now they'll set things up. Looking for Soko. Soko likes to operate in the open court. Harimoto, the big man. Soko will go to the wing. Nice basket there from Takumi Saito. And we are tied at 23. Second deadlock of the ball game. Just about 90 seconds remaining here. First quarter action, of course. Shinoyama. Making that look so easy, but not going to get the shot. There might be a foul. It's going to be on Ray Ray Parks. Take your pick, Soko or Parks? You're saying there's a slight nudge? A minute 15 remaining here. Checking in for the first time, Keisuke Masuda. That's a quick basket. And just like that, a 2-point lead enjoyed by Kawasaki. Better answer back. Suda will give it up. That's not going to drop there for Takumi Saito. He thought about it. We'll give it to Shinoyama. Shinoyama will come up short. Defense. 33 seconds remaining here in the first. Nice basket. A lot of patience shown there by Takumi Saito. Waited for the opening. Finally got it. Knocked that one down. And once again, we are deadlocked at 25. Time though for the final shot. Six seconds remaining. Being really aggressive there is Jordan Heath. Heath waiting for his time there here at the free throw line. Nagoya already in the penalty. Heath is second. 6.6 remaining on the clock before we end the first quarter. There are some fouls that Kawasaki can give, actually one foul to give, and they give it there. So 5 seconds remain in the clock. We gotta speed it up. High floaters, not gonna drop. And we're done with the first period here. Good start, 11-0 blast by the Kawasaki Brave Thunders. A good rally put together by Nagoya. But in the end, Kawasaki leads 27-25. ...50% shooting from both these squads from three-point distance has really kept it close. Good scoring from both these squads. 27 points for Kawasaki, 25 for Nagoya at the end of the first period. And look at the numbers. 4 out of 8 for Kawasaki, 3 out of 6 for Nagoya. Can they keep up this scorching pace? Let's find out. Pablo Aguilar will be starting out for his squad as the import, together with Jordan Heath for Kawasaki. On the other side, Ovi Soko, the lone import. Watch it here. Sean Dennis saying, my player didn't do anything. He got a hip check from Jordan Heath. Open three, yes! Sean Dennis throws his hands up in the air as he saw Maeta take that shot uncontested. Now it's a 5-point lead. Nice move there from Harimoto. Tenketsu Harimoto, standing 6'6", he's 29 years old. Harimoto with a good contribution yesterday. He had 10 points and 1 rebound in that victory of Nagoya over Kawasaki. He was feeling it yesterday, not to mention the fact that that big wide body of his has gotten so many boards. Two free throws gonna cut the lead down here of Kawasaki to 3. Shimiyama. Aguilar will put up a three and hit. Scorching shooting from both these squads. 60% shooting now. 6 out of 10 for the Brave Thunders, and answering right back on the other side. Can they keep up the pace shooting from downtown? 3-point lead still enjoyed by Kawasaki. That's a perfect pass, but it's given out. Open three. Bang! They can't miss. Keisuke Masuda this time. Lead is back up to 6. One stood at a high of 11. Aguilar with a nice low 5 there from his coach Kenji Sato. Yutaro Suda will check back in together with Ray Ray Parks. Both these coaches have been shuffling their players in and out so well. Cody Clark in the ball game as well. Nice basket from the outside there from Suda. They've been answering every single three here. Put up by Kawasaki. Now to set things down. Going inside the paint. The foul's going to be called there. That might be on Suda. He doesn't like the call. Very quickly, 2 minutes gone here in the second period. Came in with a swipe, and they're saying it was a little bit of arm. Scott Etherton back. Monster numbers for him yesterday. 14 points, 18 rebounds, and 7 assists. Nice look there at Pablo Aguilar. Had a quiet day yesterday at 7 points, 2 rebounds, and 3 steals. Lead is now up to 5, 38 to 33. Almost a steal. Now they got numbers the other way. Of defense, Clark will turn the corner and get fouled. Foul will go on Keisuke Masuda. Again, chance of defense. Nice release pass. Scott Etherton, no. There by Ray Ray Parks. Etherton just couldn't drop it. Shinoyama asking for a pick. Heath comes out. That's a well-run play. Misdirection there up high. And then you go inside to Masuda, who now has 5 points. Wild pass goes to Parks. Just puts up a three, will miss though. Shinoyama. That's a nice setup job. 3 free throws coming up here now. That's a very poor foul from Suda. The lead is back up to 7. Could be 10 with these free throws coming up. And that's the 3rd personal foul on Yutaro Suda. There was no space for Maeta to come down. He's there again, trying to state his case. Maeta, though, quickly to the line for 3 shots, makes the first. Second's going to be short. look at the leading scores for both these squads. Yuma Fuji leading the Brave Thunders with 8, followed by 7 from Masuda. Now Masuda's got still 7. Maeta will add to his tally though. Scott Etherton with 8 points for Nagoya, followed by Clark with 6, and 5 for Harimoto. Speaking of Harimoto, he's checking back in now, together with Tatsuya Ito, their backup point. Park splits the double team. Six minutes 35 remaining here in the first half. It's a 9-point lead enjoyed by Kawasaki. Aguilar puts up a 3. Short that time. Another board for Scott. Etherton now has 4 boards. Clark. Harimoto. And he hits. The 6-6 forward. He's got a nice touch from the outside. That's going to cut the lead down to 6. You like the patience here. Shinoyama, a little bit too strong. Duty foul there. A bit of frustration there on Ito. No chance he could have gotten the rebound there. Just pushed. Yuma Fuji back in the ball game together with the King. There's Fazekas. The King gives it back. Goes to his position. Another board here for Scott, and he's off and running, trying to lead the break. Sets up Clark. Secondary break, they go to Parks. Parks left open. No. Scott on offensive rebound. Has to barrel his way in. We'll have to give it up. Park shaking, baking, going to the rack for 2. And he got fouled in the process. He's got 6 points, looking for point number 7 with his free throw. Watch it once again. Getting away, made sure there was a bump. That's too easy there for Ray Ray Parks. Janning checking back in. Maeda gave them very good numbers. So did Masuda. That's a violation. Hitting the back of the backboard. That's why a lot of coaches will stress to their players, when you're taking it out after a made basket, move to the side. Don't stay directly under that basket. And now, it's just a 3-point lead. Could be tied. Harimoto just short. Scott saves it to the wrong individual. Yuma Fuji to Nick. Nick open 3. Bang! Exactly 5 minutes remaining here in the second period. And it's a 6-point lead enjoyed by the King and company. You leave him open, that's a no-no. We're at the midway point of our second period. Nagoya already in the penalty here for the final 5 minutes. Can Kawasaki take advantage? Ito will have to bring it out. Find Scott. Clark, nice lead pass. That's great defense there from Nick, but in the end, Scott's still going to get his 2 points. Hockey assist there, really, from Ray Ray Parks. Poor foul going to be called there on Ito. Looking a little hurt. Now he says he's okay. Well, he slammed into Yuma Fuji and then bumped into Ray Ray Parks. Back in the ball game, Takumi Saito, the starting point guard here for the boys in white. As the trainer works on Ito there on the bench, you can see it. At the end of the bench of Coach Sean Dennis. Two free throws there for Yuma Fuji. Fuji now in double digits with 10 points. He also has 2 assists. They want nothing less than a victory here. Clark with a floater. That'll drop. Is that going to be an offensive foul called here? Check that. It's going to be a loose ball foul called on Ray Ray Parks. And so that's going to mean free throws. As you ram that play, you can see he just rammed into the defender. Going to be the third personal foul on Ray Ray Parks. He's going to see limited minutes in the third. But Hasegawa can't hit. Wry smile there on the face of Ray Ray Parks because he knows he's going to be in the doghouse for a while. There he gets replaced. Chance now of defense. 48-43 is our tally. Exactly 4 minutes remaining here in the second period. Kawasaki with a 5-point advantage. Clark. Might have been an offensive foul. Forces the issue. No call, but not able to get that shot to drop anyhow. Fuji, we look for the King. King, nice drop step. Just put it up. Scott Etherton grabs that. Now they got numbers the other way. If Clark will push the issue. Harimoto for three. No. Aguilar with a nice rebound. That would have really helped. Fuji. Poor pass. Late call, but nonetheless, there was a foul there in Yuma Fuji. That'll be the third team foul here for Kawasaki. Got a timeout on the floor. 3:15 remaining in this one. Talking about the first half, of course, and it's a 5-point lead by the Kawasaki Brave Thunders. little over 3 minutes remaining here in the second period. Diamond Dolphins with possession, but they're trailing by five. Could be two, yes! Nice floater there from Takumi Saito. He's got 8 points. Looking at his performance yesterday, Saito had 12 points, 3 rebounds, and 8 assists. Now he's trying to get confirmation on exactly what happened there in the stoppage of play. That was a looping shot. That counted. What are they looking at? Well, they're saying it might be delay of game. Let's see. It is. Fazikas will miss. One of the few times you're going to see Nick struggling from that free throw line. And now both teams in the penalty. Kawasaki here in the final 3 minutes. Nagoya has been in the penalty for the last five. Fuji stopped in his tracks. Janning. Bounce pass finds Pablo Aguilar. And the lead's back up to four. 7 points now in the contest for Aguilar. That matches his output from yesterday. Nothing there in that three. It's going to fall in the hands of Obisoko though. Suda. Ill-advised pass. As we approach the last 2 minutes of the first half. Nick denied. Second serving works. The King already in double digits. He just makes the game look so easy. Naturalized player of Japan. The King. Harimoto forces that one. Ill-advised. We're gonna walk it up. The King will give it back to Yuma Fuji. Let's see if the King will try to take it. Finds Janning. Janning hits from the outside. And just like that, the lead is back up to 9. 6 points in the contest here for Janning. Matt Janning is perfect so far from three. Nice drop step, and Obisoko on the board. He's been on the floor for 7 minutes and finally scores. He has added a rebound. 3 rebounds, in fact, and an assist. Janning. Good pass. Yuma Fuji will come up short. Aguilar trying to tap it to himself. Clark clears. Under a minute to be played here. Nice early seal. They're going to count the basket. Obisoko with a heads-up play. He heard the whistle. He put it up. Watch it here. Early entry pass there from Saito. No question about that being counted. 37.8 seconds remaining. A timeout will be called here. Ovi Soko now on the line, looking to complete a three-point play to bring his team even closer. They were down by 9 a few seconds earlier. That's not going to drop. Deficit still at 5. That's a perfect pass. Yuma Fuji with the easy layup. Fazekas from one end to the next. That caught the defense napping. Lead is back up to 7. Almost a steal. It's completed. Fuji inside. Aguilar can't hit. Now Clark says we're going to go for the last shot. Both teams in the penalty, so no fouls to give. The pass intercepted. Aguilar. That would have counted. It was close. But two quarters done here at the Todoroki Arena. And the fans of the Kawasaki Brave Thunders cheering loudly. And why not? Their team is up by 7. 57-50. And now let's take a look at the highlights of the first two quarters of play. Yuma Fuji steps back and hits a shot. That got him on the board, 3-0. And back-to-back turnovers here for the boys in white. And the King makes them pay. They would go out to a 8-0 run. Janning continues to hit. That built their lead to 11-1. Another three there for Yuma Fuji made it 14-3. And then Scott Etherton trying to put back some semblance of order. And they plugged away. And then he eventually tied it at 18. Yuma Fuji getting away for a twinner. The King kissing it off the glass, getting fouled. Parks losing it. Kawasaki once again scoring on the break. Taking advantage of so many turnovers, 9 turnovers for the Nagoya Diamond Dolphins. But starting to find his range was Takumi Saito. First period ended with Kawasaki on top, 27-25. That's nice patience shown there by Masuda. And then Ray Parks with a 3-point play of his own. Janning finding the King. He gets denied on the first opportunity, but he sticks with it. Watch it here. Easy spin, asking for a foul, not given. Obisoko will miss. Look at that pinpoint pass. Touchdown there for Yuma Fuji. And these are the numbers. 58% two-point shooting as compared to 60% shooting for the Nagoya Diamond Dolphins. But they made their move because of the three-point shooting and also because they had 5 more free throws. Talking about the Kawasaki Brave Thunders. They also had 1 turnover less. Check that, 4 turnovers less. 18-20, those are the points in the paint. So Nagoya actually had 2 more. Bench points, definitely in favor here. +9 for the Kawasaki Brave Thunders. Rebounding just about even. 16-15 in favor of Kawasaki. And looking at assists, 15-12. +3 in favor of the Brave Thunders. Let's check out the leading scorers for both these squads. All right, now first, let's take a look at the head-to-head matchup. The King with 11. Scott Etherton with 10. Fazekas with 3 rebounds, 8 boards for Etherton. And they have 2 assists each. Leading scorers for both these squads at the half. Yuma Fuji with 12. Nick with 11. And Masuda with 7. These are actually the leaders in points, rebounds, and assists. So Fuji there with 12 points. Aguilar with 4 rebounds, same amount of rebounds as Nick, and Shinoyama's got 5 assists. On the other side, 10 points for Scott Etherton. He also has 8 rebounds, and Takumi Saito has 4 assists. That sets up an exciting second half, that's for sure. We'd like to welcome you back to the Todoroki Arena. the home of the Kawasaki Brave Thunders. These two squads faced each other yesterday, and Nagoya won that one, 89-85. So right now, Kawasaki, with a 7-point lead, would want to get right back at their tormentors of Saturday afternoon. Scott Etherton was one of the heroes yesterday for his squad with 14 points, 18 rebounds, and 7 assists. And right now, good contributions with 10-8. Cody Clark and company with first possession here. Etherton, nice extra pass. Clark for three. That's going to cut the lead down to 4. Well-run offensive set. They push it forward. Heath. He's been quiet. The King passes it up there. Hasegawa will miss. Heath is a really tall, long individual. Standing 6'10". And he's got hops. Last year, I remember we honored him for having 100 dunks here in the B-League. Scott Etherton will miss. Hasegawa clears. Gets it to Janning. They push it forward with Yuma Fuji. Fuji puts up a 3 and hits! They continue to scorch the hoops from downtown, shooting well over 50%. Scott finds Suda. Suda in the paint, tries to kiss it off the glass, no. Janning likes to take control. They'll go inside. Nick kicks it out. Fuji brings it closer. Finds Janning open for 3. No. Long rebound will go to Yuma. They set up Heath. Heath for 3. Boy, he overshot that one. Ill-advised entry there from Takumi Saito. He'll give it up. Cody Clark with a frustration foul there. Just to stop the action. I'm not quite sure why he did that though, because that's going to be his third personal foul, as you can see there on your screens. So he might have to be replaced. Yuma Fuji hits it once again. He's got 2 threes here in the third period, and a timeout will have to be called by Coach Sean Dennis. He says enough is enough. Yuma Fuji already with 18 points, and we're still here in the early goings of the third period. Early timeout had to be called by Coach Sean Dennis. Let's see if that timeout will help. Floater is going to fall short there for Ito. Also replaced there was Takumi Saito. He wasn't really controlling the pace. To the liking of coach Sean Dennis, Clark kicks it out. Suda for three. They can't answer. Etherton. To Clark. Another offensive rebound here for Scott. Ito inside the paint. Finds Clark. Clark, another attempt. Yes, finally gets it to drop. That's going to cut the lead down here. And 14 points in the contest for Cody Clark. Still a comfortable 7-point lead here for Kawasaki. They've had a lead of as big as 11 in the first half. The King inside. Felt the contact, heard the whistle, put it up. He's a real smart player. He's a veteran in every sense of the word. He's got great hands. Saw that. Felt the swipe, put it up. And he's now on the line for two shots. Nick, the King. Fazekas is going to miss his first free throw, though. Fazekas is 36 years old, standing 6'11". Played for the Mavs and the Clippers in the NBA, and right now he's lording it over here in Japan. Clark looking for back-to-back threes. No. Scott Etherton saying, okay, I'm a little younger here than Nick, so I should be able to get these offensive boards. Look at him battling inside with the big boys. Doesn't have as much length as Nick does, but he's got those spry young legs. On the line now is Scott. Makes that first free throw. That's a good look at coach Sean Dennis. He coached Shiga last season. That's one of the main reasons I believe he brought in Obi Soko. He is very comfortable with Obi. Coached him last season, and now they acquired him. Obi Soko has played just 5 games. But they're looking for a playoff push. Yuma gets it off to Hasegawa. Shot clock is at 2. Janning, 4th shot. Will come up short. Parks with the rebound. Looks like he got tripped up. And Hasegawa all over the place there. Took advantage of the fact that Parks was on the floor. Watch it here. Parks gets that long rebound. Gets tripped up by his own teammate. And then on the floor tying him up was Hasegawa. Nice close-up shot there of Ito. The ball is going to stay here on this end of the floor. Because possession arrow shows the boys in red, and Janning hits. Janning with 9 points, all on threes. And the lead is back up to 9. Clark tries to respond, no. And they're going to say, we're going to the other side. Parks can't believe it. Neither can coach Sean Dennis. Let's see exactly what happened there. Well, it came off the heel of Parks, who was already outside. Foul's going to be called there in Ito. That's going to be his 3rd. Fuji quickly comes out to get it. The King with a handoff. Yuma Fuji inside. Janning with a floater will come up short. And again, the King not even coming down. Puts it up and through. Fazekas now with 14 points to go with 4 rebounds and 4 assists. That's going to stay here in this end. As we approach the halfway mark of the 3rd period. Nice swipe there. Scott We're going to call a foul. It's going to be on Hasegawa. Hasegawa, a lot of times, stands a little too close. Got caught that time. There it was in the replay. He was asking for an offensive foul. That's going to be his third personal, though. .511 still to be played here in the third. Once again, operating on the outside, Clark. He's got the foot speed against Fazekas, but Fazekas comes out on top there. He'll bring it down. Looks for Heath inside. That's well played by the King. 6 points now for Heath. Heath yesterday also just with 8 points, 8 rebounds. But today he's really picking his spot. Scott Etherton replies quickly. He's got 14 points. A still ball of Kawasaki. Here comes Obi Soko. We mentioned him earlier as being one of the favorites of Coach Sean Dennis. Quick hands, a chance for the boys in white to score here. And they're going to say it's an unsportsmanlike foul. They're going to review this one just to confirm it. As the referees head over to the table, let's see exactly what transpired. Quick hands there from Cody Clark. Soko got away. Now you can see exactly why they were asking for it. And actually, it was initially given because he wrapped his arms around Ovi Soko and came away with a little tug. But initially, he was going for the ball. So if they deem it to be a regular foul, there won't be any question. But if they deem it an unsportsmanlike foul, you'll also understand where the referees are coming from. You can see the swipe. And there, they affirm that it is an unsportsmanlike foul. So, two unsportsmanlike fouls already called here on the boys in red earlier in the first quarter. Hasegawa was called for one. And there, Takumi Saito now. No, it's Obi Soko heading to the line for two. Check that. So Yuma Fuji will be given the second unsportsmanlike foul called on the hometown Brave Thunders. Soko makes both. And they've got ball possession here. They can cut it down even further. Soko gets fouled. Heath can't believe it. He felt it was all ball. Nick was there once again. In the mix, they're looking at confirmation. Let's see exactly what transpired. Perfect pass, though. Oh, they're going to call the foul not on Heath. That's going to be on Nick. His second foul. There's a little bit of a hand check there. Soko makes the second. And the deficit has been cut down to 8. Under 4 to be played here in the third. The King trying to make his move. You can't allow him to get that close, because he can create for himself and at the same time find an open teammate. The foul is going to be called there on Obi Soko. That's Soko's second personal foul. And the King on the line once again. Nick with 14 points. Make that 15 points. 6 boards and 5 dimes. He continues to just churn out these numbers that are very impressive. We got a jam-packed Todoroki Arena, and why not? They knew this was a good one. Clark, extra pass. Harimoto will give it up. Soko attacks. That was a good pass in the last instant. Problem is, Ito can't do anything inside that paint. Here's when he can do damage. Can't hit that jumper though. Credit to Obi Soko for keeping that one alive. They're gonna get a brand new 14. Both teams already in the penalty here. Yuma Fuji getting a hand to that one. Checking the leading scores for both squads. Yuma Fuji's got 18. Scott Etherton with 14. Scott's on the bench. Clark for 3. Back rims that one. Fuji gets there first. And now they're going to call an unsportsmanlike foul this time on Cody Clark. And that's going to slow things down because they're going to check. They're going to double and triple check if this is the right call. Well, it looks like Cody Clark made a play for the basketball. This could be reversed. But the problem is, for a big guy making contact with a smaller individual, it looks a little graver than it usually is. They're going to review this one. Watch it here. This is a better angle. Well, he was going for the ball. He made contact there with the left hand. Let's see what they're going to deem. And they're going to affirm. And now Cody Clark's going to be ejected. That's his fourth personal foul, but they're making a motion that he's got to leave the court. So Cody Clark is done for the day. Wow. That's a big turn of events here. So now they're going to have to send Scott Etherton back in action. Yuma Fuji's got 2 free throws. He's going to make the first. And it's ball possession here for Kawasaki. A little embattled now is the squad of Sean Dennis. Second free throw drops as well. The lead is increased to 12. It once stood at the high of 13 at 71-58. Yutaro Suda checking back in. Carino also on the floor as well. He only played about a minute and a half in the first half. You have not seen too much of Ryusei Shinoyama, the star of Kawasaki. He's been used sparingly today, but they're not missing him. Everybody's picked up the slack. Open 3, bang! Kuma guy left open. He had all day to shoot. He's got 7 points now. And the lead is now at 15, 78-63. Etherton with the offensive rebound. They're not going to get that to drop. And here's Janning. Bring it past the timeline. Janning left open. Line drive three short. Suda pushes it forward. Open three, Carino. That's going to rim out. The King tracks it behind the back outlet. And here they come once again, pushing it forward. Janning. The King. He forces the issue. One of the few times you'll see him force it. Etherton inside, gets two. He's got 16 points, and a timeout will be called here by Kawasaki. Under 2 minutes to be played here in the third. Kawasaki on top by 13. And they've got possession. The King finds Heath. Extra pass to the wing. That was halfway down. Chance here for Nagoya. We've not seen too much of Parks. Inside, Ovi Soko. Quite surprising. Parks did quite well in the first half. The King for three. Bang! Lead is back up to 14. Nick really picks his spots perfectly. Des Parks at the end of the bench. He looks okay, but as they say, coach's decision. Extra pass. Etherton hits. That's going to add to his tally. He's got 18 points now. Under a minute to be played here in the third. They've got some ground to catch up, but not that bad. There's a poor pass from Yuma Fuji. Off the break. 2-on-2 break. Kumagai's going to be called for that one. He's not too happy with the call. Well, actually, if you look at it in the replay, it didn't look like there was a lot of contact. But live, it looked like there was more than there actually was. Shinoyama's now going to check in. They're going to give him a little bit of a breather here. As he sets up, fixes his uniform now. Suda with two shots. And I get this deficit down to 10. First is a little too strong. The team of Sean Dennis still in this one. But they need to make these free throws. Look at the free throw situation. Diamond Dolphins shooting 76%. 78% here for Kawasaki. Two misses though that time, and it's going Kawasaki's way. So the lead still at 12. A lot of missed opportunities for the boys in white. Gotta take advantage of these. Shinoyama, release pass. Finds the king. The king will come up short. Pablo Aguilar with an offensive rebound and shot clock's off. Just about. A lot of contact there. They take play on. Aguilar for three. Back rims that one. That long rebound is not going to give Nagoya a chance to be able to take a shot. So as we head into the fourth, still comfortably ahead, we've got the Kawasaki Brave Thunders, 69. And welcome to the fourth and final quarter here this Sunday afternoon. We're coming to you from the Todoroki Arena, the home of the Kawasaki Brave Thunders, as they host the Nagoya Diamond Dolphins. Jumper's not going to work for Suda, but the tip-in will. That's going to cut the lead down to 10. Another good start here for Nagoya. Problem is they start out the quarter strong, but they falter in the finish. Once again, if you're just joining us, this is the second of back-to-back encounters between these two squads here this weekend. Yesterday, Nagoya won 89-84. So Kawasaki would want nothing less than a victory right now to even things off this weekend. Both these teams in third place in their respective divisions. The king, a little bit too strong. Again, Kawasaki with another offensive rebound. Here's Janning. Janning, a little bit too strong. Scott gives it up. We'll get it back. Just one man to beat. He goes to the corner. Carino for three. No. The tap goes to Obi Soko, though. That should be an assist there for Scott Etherton. Heads-up play there for Scott. 1:05 gone very quickly here in the fourth. Golden opportunity there for Carino to get his team even closer. Shinoyama who's staying on the floor as Naoya Kumagai picks up his fourth. But Kumagai made sure there was no easy two. And now we have Ray Ray Parks in the ball game. But for the Filipino fans and the fans of Nagoya, they're hoping he finishes out this ball game. Especially without Cody Clark. Cody Clark, if again you're just joining us, has been ejected for two unsportsmanlike fouls. There's a steal. Soko with a big slam. And the lead is down to six. That's what we talked about. The boys in white always start quarter strong, except for the first period. But they falter in the latter stage. Can they keep it going here? Can they make it back-to-back at the Todoroki Arena? Shinoyama will go to Janning. Shaking, baking, gives it up. Shinoyama for three. Yes! Their star, Ryoshe. Parks looks to answer. It does! Parks didn't play in the third. Has come in here in the fourth. And he's making up for lost time. The King. That's a pinpoint pass. Back-to-back baskets here for Shinoyama. He's got 5 points. All of them here in the payoff period. Etherton will miss. Soko battling inside. Nick saying he got pushed in the back. That cuts the lead back down to six. Waiting for the play to develop. They go to Shinoyama. Extra pass. That's an assist for Shinoyama. Spotting up was Masuda. They just moved that ball around so well. Etherton kicks it out. Suda for three. Short. He'll track it down. Kisses it off the glass there. He's got 5 points. Talking about Suda. It's been a real shootout here to start out the fourth and final period. And Shinoyama has been at the forefront of the attack of the Brave Thunders. Janning misfires. Here's Soko in the open court. We'll give it up. Takumi Saito tries to look for Ovi Soko. Watch that play develop. Foul's going to be called on Masuda. It was actually a second motion on Pablo Aguilar. But the referee say, play on. Now Nick's going to be replaced. They need him for the end game. And they send in very tall, very athletic Jordan Heath. Parks, pocket pass, finds Scott. Assist going to Ray Ray Parks. And Etherton is now at 20 points. And more importantly, the lead has been cut down to four. They send a double. Etherton gets down and dirty, but unfortunately made contact there with the sideline. The ball will stay on this end. But you can see the boys in red, a little embattled at this stage. ...6:15 to be played. We got a good one here this Sunday afternoon, that's for sure. Almost a 5 second violation. Shinoyama quickly attacks. They're gonna call the foul on Nagoya. That's gotta hurt. How do you stop somebody like Jordan Heath? Heath looks over, says, too small. As he makes a sprint towards the basket, and in his way there was Takumi Saito. Funny, because Takumi Saito was the one who apologized when he got the raw end of that one. And he picked up the foul. Shinuyama for three. Yes, he's got two threes and a twinner inside. He's got 8 points, all of them here in the fourth. Japanese national player has come up big here in the fourth. That's why Coach Kenji has been preserving him for a strong finishing kick. Coming to the basket, extra pass. Heath with a slam. And a foul's going to be called there on Bobby Ray Parks. Those instances, you just give it to Heath. When he goes up, you can't stop him. Watch it here. Extra pass. Parks thought he could get hold of the ball. Just a fraction of a second late. Heath now on the line for an extra free throw. It's going to be the fourth personal foul here on Ray Ray Parks. So Parks with four. Clark out of the ball game. Let's see where they go. Parks extricates. They'll reset the offense. Saito finds Scott. Scott hits. Scott now with 22 points to lead all scorers. Yuma Fuji leading the scoring for the Kawasaki Brave Thunders, but he's on the bench. They might send him in the final 3 minutes. Foul's going to be called there on Suda. That's going to be the third team foul of Nagoya. Still not there in the penalty. Check that. They're saying they're going to give that on number 12, Taito Nakahigashi. That's another nice look. Parks might have fouled there. He dodged the bullet. Falling away, not going to work. Nakahigashi pushing. Pushing still. Find Soko, who overshoots. Aguilar with the rebound. Shinuyama. That's not going to drop. Heath with the offensive rebound. And they're going to burn clock once again. Quick three. No. Ito picks it up. He's going to be fouled. That's going to bring us to our technical timeout here. Helter Skelter Basketball. 6-point lead enjoyed by Kawasaki as we step away. Right now, the officials are going to be going through their monitor to be able to check on something. Not quite sure exactly what. But there's 4 minutes 15 seconds remaining in this contest. A 6-point lead enjoyed by Kawasaki. Cody Clark is out. He's been ejected. Ray Ray Parks with 4 personal fouls. And I'm not quite sure exactly what they're looking at here. There's 20 seconds on the shot clock, which is actually just right because it's a fresh possession. There was an early foul, so they don't reset that to 14. They keep it at where it is. Sean Dennis allowing the officials to make their call. Once again, the 3 officials that we've got helping us out this afternoon. You got referee Okawara, referee Hosoda, and referee Akiyama. Are they looking at the clock? Well, 2 officials conspiring on that one. Now they're going to talk to both coaches to at least inform them of what is happening. Unfortunately, we can't quite hear their conversation. There's Coach Kenji Sato. And right in front of him, Coach Sean Dennis. There he is, together with his assistant. Well, both coaches agree. I guess that's the most important. But see, even our table officials are a little beleaguered. Now we're going to get the announcement. We'll get word to you once we find out exactly what that was all about. Scott there talking to Sean Dennis, trying to get exactly what happened. So now they officially change it. It is 94-86. So apparently the scores were incorrectly displayed, and now it's displayed properly. Parks gets knocked down. So that's the official score. An 8-point lead for Kawasaki. So a score was missed there, and so they've set things straight, and that on your screens is now official. 94 Kawasaki, 86 Nagoya. Parks, we lose it there to Aguilar. Scott's gonna pick it up. Not exactly a must score situation, but definitely if you're the boys in white, you want to be able to score here. Nakahigashi is going to lose it. And here's their main man, Riesei Shinoyama, who has come alive here in the fourth. Aguilar puts up a three. That would have been the dagger. Obisoko picks it up. Attacks. Gets away, but will miss that layup. They get it out. They push it forward. And now they'll use some clock. Heath back to Shinoyama. They spread the floor. Yuma Fuji getting ready to check back in. There's a steal for Etherton. This will be a walk in the park. And they cut the lead down to six. Still everything hanging in the balance here. Shinoyama says, I'll bring it down myself, despite the double team. Gets it back. And then use clock again. Heath inside. Easy slam. Lead is back up to eight. Heath now in double digits with 11. Parks inside the paint. Gets at the drop. Basket and one opportunity here for Ray Ray Parks. Pablo Aguilar complaining about something, but Parks says, never mind. I got a three-point play to convert. 2-2 remaining in this ball game. Fouling out is Keisuke Maseda. And here comes Yuma Fuji back in action. He is the leading scorer for the Kawasaki Brave Thunders, and only now he's being reinserted. He converts a three-point play. And Parks will be replaced. They gotta preserve him for the offensive end. So offense, defensive substitution is gonna be happening now. As you heard him there, as he sat down, he shouted, one stop. They're still down five. Shinoyama. That's good hands there from Scott Etherton. The problem is here, unlike in pro ball, you can call a timeout and send Parks back in, but hitting there was Takumi Saito, and that cuts the lead down to three. Under 2 minutes to be played here as we enter the Twilight Zone, the business end of this one. Here we go! Shinoyama left open, can hit. Pablo Aguilar has gotten so many offensive rebounds as they have Nick the King Fazekas on the bench. Shinoyama finds Aguilar, extra pass. Hasegawa! That's a big shot. Under a minute and 20 remaining. Lead is back up to six. Obisoko, poor pass. And we're going in the other direction. And he knew it. 64 seconds remaining. Not the most comfortable of margins. And now time to get Bobby Ray Parks back in the ball game. It's now or never. Chance of Kawasaki here at the Todoroki Arena. If they score here, that could be it. But they lose possession. Saito. Stutter step. Suda for three, short. Nice rebound there from Jordan Heath. They might have to foul. Precious seconds ticking away, and there's the foul from Suda. 30.1 seconds remaining, and two free throws coming up here. Suda will be replaced. In is Ray Ray Parks. Nagoya actually not getting the penalties. They got one more foul to give. Ray Ray Parks with four, so he can't foul. Well, they went to Aguilar. Soko with the foul there. Soko picking up his third. And you can see the little grimace there a while ago from Coach Sean Dennis, because at that stage, I don't think he wanted to bring in Ray Ray Parks, because Parks had four. He couldn't foul. But it worked out well. They went to Aguilar. He got fouled by Soko. But the problem is, he's going to make this free throw. It's now going to be a three-possession ball game. Essentially, Kawasaki in the clear. Remember, they lost yesterday, 89-84, here. With 29 seconds remaining, they're up by 8 at 101-93. A timeout will be called by Coach Sean Dennis. We'll be back. They got a score here. They're trying. Hariyama with a three. No. And look at Pablo Aguilar not even giving up the 2 points. They actually could have just given that one. They're still up by 8. Harimoto definitely needed that one. Two free throws now here. And again, Nagoya will just, regardless of what happens to these two free throws, might have to foul just to extend the game. seconds remaining. This, for all intents and purposes, barring a major mishap, is a victory here for Kawasaki. Still a two-possession ball game with a 6-point lead. Suda is going to check back in. No, that's Nakahigashi checking in. For Ray Ray Parks. Park can't foul. He's got four. They couldn't send in Suda as well. And now they're going to send Ray Ray right back after that foul. But Yuma Fuji will head to the line though for two free throws first. 12.7 seconds remaining. Well, you like the fact that Nagoya is still trying. But it's essentially, as I said, a one ball game here for Kawasaki. They're up by 6. Even a split from the free throw line here from Yuma Fuji will make it a 3-possession ball game. And he makes the first. So Kawasaki will get back at their Saturday tormentor, Nagoya Diamond Dolphins. They lost yesterday 89-84. They're going to win this one going away. And a timeout will be called by Coach Sean Dennis. His final timeout. Just wanted to score here, possibly for the Koshin. Saito puts up a three. Will come up short. Soko gives it back out. They're definitely looking for a three. Saito won't get at the drop, and that will be the end of the ball game. Kawasaki's going to win this one with a score of 103 to 95. Well played ball game. Today we had the battle of teams that were in third place in their respective divisions. As we take a look at the quarter scoring, it has closed all throughout except for that third. Actually, even the second. Kawasaki built a 5-point lead there. Got another 5 points in the third quarter. They were outscored in the fourth, but in the end, they had more than enough to come away with the victory here. The King did his job early, and he rested late. Kawasaki Brave Thunders will now improve to 32 victories against 11 setbacks, while the Nagoya Diamond Dolphins will fall to 25 and 12. In just a bit, we're going to hear from the winning squad, starting out with Coach Kenji Sato. You might hear from, definitely I think we're going to hear from Yuma Fuji, who top scored 22 points. Risei Shinoyama came up with a strong fourth period, scoring all of his 8 points. So you might hear from him as well. Nick, the King, had 19 points. Jordan Heath had 11. Pablo Aguilar helped out rebounding-wise. He had 8. The King had 7. And Heath had 4. So almost 20 rebounds contributed by the three international imports. Assists-wise, Fuji with 6. Same number as Shinoyama. And also Nick the King. So 18 assists divided equally among Fuji, Shinoyama, and Fazekas. In a losing effort, Ito had 6 coming off the bench. Saito, their starter, had 6. And Scott Etherton contributed 3. Here now we have Coach Kenji Sato.
ご来場の皆様、配信視聴していただいている皆様、大変長らくお待たせいたしました。これより勝利チームヘッドコーチ、MVPインタビューに入らせていただきます。本日激戦で見事勝利を収めました川崎ブレイブサンダー佐藤健二ヘッドコーチです。勝利おめでとうございます。ありがとうございます。激しい試合でした。しっかりと昨日のリベンジを果たしました。試合振り返っていかがですか。
はい、昨日本当に悔しい負けだったので、もう絶対にやり返そうということで、
今日は本当に選手集中して出た選手強み出して頑張ってくれました。皆さんのサポートのおかげです。ありがとうございました。まあ、あえてお伺いしますが、その昨日から今日勝利を収めることができた要因はどのあたりにあると考えていますか。試合前にもう一度チームで戦おうということで、お互い信じてチームで戦う、それをもう40分表現できたことだと思います。
そしてもう一つ本当に今日ですね、ファミリーの皆さんの応援すごかったです。それを受けて次はアウェイ戦ですね。リーグの後半戦、終盤戦に入ってるんですけども、終盤戦の戦い方についてはどのように考えていますか。スケジュールが本当に、水曜ゲームも入って土日も試合あってタフなスケジュールが続くので、できるだけ多くの選手コートに立ってチーム
で戦っていく、これがこれからの川崎のバスケット、そこにぜひ注目してほしいと思います。次節アウェー戦も頑張ってください。最後にもう一言お願いします。はい、ずっとアウェーが続いてたので、直接お伝えできなかったので、ここで、ちょっと言わせていただきます。天皇杯優勝できました。皆さんのおかげです。 本当に、サンダースファミリーの皆さんのサポートがあって、我々こうやって試合をすることができます。次はリーグチャンピオン目指していきますので、引き続きサポートよろしくお願いします。ありがとうございました。
佐藤源ジェットコーチでした。天皇杯連覇、そして今日もねしっかりと勝ち姿を見せてくれました。続いて本日の MVP の発表です。本日 MVP に選出されたのはNo.22 ニック・ファンスイカーズ。コングラチュレーションズ、ニック。まずはニック選手、 MVP 選出おめでとうございます。
ありがとうございます。
Here now we have Nick the King。
いや本当に両チームのね気持ちがぶつかり合う激しい試合でした。試合振り返っていかがですか？
You know, obviously we lost yesterday. We came back. We're a little disappointed. So we just wanted to make sure we got the win today.
昨日の敗戦を得てやっぱり少し、がっかりした部分があったので、そこをしっかりと見直して今日はしっかり勝とうっていう話でできて、今日勝ててよかったと思っています。
そして今日はメモリアル、ご自身の B リーグ通算スリーポイントシュート400回成功もありました。この記録についてはどう感じていますか？
Yeah, obviously it's you know, just another I guess record for me. Obviously it's fun to sort of rack them up as I get older. Obviously time is coming to an end here shortly, so it's fun to see that sort of stuff be accomplished.
で自分の記録達成というのがまた一つ増えて、本当に良かったなというふうに思っています。で自分自身ももう若くはならないのでだんだんと年も取ってきているのでもう少し、まだプレーできる時間が残っているか分からないですけど、まあ、こういったように、記録をどんどん積み重ねていけて良かったと思っています。
まあ、メモリアルは他にももちろんあります。
Well, Nick has played so long andBefore he retires, he's going to own a whole lot more records.
Four of them, it feels pretty good. Obviously, this is my 10th year, so we've won almost half. Going back to back, I think will always kind of be special. That's not an easy tournament to win, and to win back to back is.Definitely something I won't ever forget.
僕川崎で10年目になるんですけど、
What he's talking about is the Emperor's Cup. And a while ago, Coach Sato also made reference to that, saying we want to follow up our Emperor's Cup victory with the league championship.
それに加えて天皇杯2連覇、
So now that is their goal.
だと思ってるので、僕のキャリアの中でこういった風に天皇杯2連覇すごく難しいんですけど、それが成し得たことすごく嬉しく思っています。
さて。次は悲願のリーグ制覇ですね。ここからの歩みについて皆さんに最後にメッセージをください。
Obviously thanks for the support. Obviously in All Japan we saw a lot of you guys there. It was really awesome. Obviously Saitama was packed. There was a lot of brave red there, so that was really cool for us to see. And we'll see how these playoffs go. We hope to see more brave red if we end up having to play on the road.
で天皇杯でも本当に応援ありがとうございました。埼玉スーパーアリーナの会場で本当に多くのファンの皆さんのブレイブレッドが見ることができて本当に良かったと思っています。でここから先、試合も続きますしアウェー戦もあるのでそこで、少しでも多く赤く染めていただければと思っているので応援の方よろしくお願いします。
はい、ニック・ファジーカス選手のコメントをいただきました。さて最後になりますが、ニック選手いつものビーブレイブで締めましょう。3、2、1、ビーブレイブでお願いします。
はい、準備いいですか？はい、1、2、3、ビーブレイブ。
Congratulations! MVP はニック・ファジーカス選手でした。さすがの。
Well, you can see he's been here for quite a while. He's a big fan favorite, and he's picked up the language as well. Nick, the King, Fazekas. leading his charge once again. And they say farewell to all the fans. Jordan Heath, Pablo Aguilar. They had a big share here in this victory just picked up by the Kawasaki Brave Thunders. They now have 32 wins. And they're looking for more. Season slowly winding down as they gear for the playoffs. And they stay solidly in third spot in their division. We'll show you the highlights of the game that just finished, and then we'll go through the numbers. Collectively, Kawasaki shot 50% from the field as compared to just 46 for Nagoya. Here was Fuji. He found his range early. And some early turnovers really did Nagoya in. The king left open for that three. And he got to 400 three-pointers made. Well, he's been at it for quite a while. He's gonna lose it though. Here comes Scott Etherton. Etherton had 24 points. And they get some points from Cody Clark while he was still in the ball game before he got ejected in the third period. They were off and running. Look at this. All the way through. We talked about everybody contributing. But Saito started to find his range. And then he got others involved. No look pass finds Suda. Up and under move. Masuda that time. First period ended, Kawasaki on top, 27-25. Radio Parks started to go to work. But the king inside, denied the first time, sticks with it. Look at this pinpoint pass. Boom. Yuma Fuji was just waiting for it. Open three is going to drop there for Cody Clark. Clark would finish with 14 points before he got ejected. The king. That might go down as an assist. Not the crispest of passes, but in the end, he found the hot man in Yuma Fuji. Clark hits once again. The ball movement was just superb here today. Janning's gonna come up short, but there's Nick once again for the putback. Actually, after two quarters of play, it was a 7-point advantage for Kawasaki at 57-50. And after three, it was 81-69 in favor of the Brave Thunders. Soko finds Etherton. And then Soko inside. the king with a three before he sat down for good. Nick would finish with 19 points. Suda with a jumper will come up short, but tipping it in there was Ovi Soko. Another steal, and Soko with an emphatic slam. Looking at the steals, there was 12 for the Brave Thunders, 11 for the Diamond Dolphins. Open three here for Parks. Swishes it through. Another side jumper. That time's not going to work for Etherton, but again, continuing to work was Ovi Soko. Assist there. Extra pass once again. Foul's going to be called on Parks. That was his fourth. Heath with another slam dunk. Twice, Shinoyama lost the ball on trying to pass it while jumping. Pinpoint passing once again, and another slam dunk there for Jordan Heath. And Hasegawa, who played tough defense all throughout, came up with a late basket there. And it's a victory. 103 to 95. Winning by 8 points are the Brave Thunder. As we take a look at the numbers, Nagoya actually shot slightly better from two-point distance, but shot a whole lot poorer from three. Free throw numbers, getting 5 more free throws was Kawasaki. Turnovers, 13 to 15, so that's in favor of the Brave Thunders. They lost the battle of inside the paint, 28 to 40, but in the end, they still just got the number that really counted, which is the points on the board. Looking at other numbers, Kawasaki actually had only 33 rebounds as compared to Nagoya's 40, but they had 7 more assists, 29 to 22. Blocks, just about even, one apiece.